Welcome back to the Rhode Show, everybody. This morning in the buzz, as we mentioned earlier in the show, the iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus have hit Apple stores and, yes, they are quickly disappearing, and I had nothing to do with it. Many tech-obsessed folks camped out for days for the big release. This is considered one of the biggest smartphone unveilings for Apple in years. But it happens almost annually. So when new technology comes out, do you find yourself wanting to be part of the craze? That is our question we have posed to you today.
I know what your answer is.
Look, I love technology. I have this old thing over here, this iPhone 5. Mm-hmm. I might as well use like two tin cans and send smoke signals. It's old. Would I like the new iPhone 6 or iPhone 6 Plus? Yes, I would. However, I'm going to stick this out. I try to convince myself that I don't need it. That convincing doesn't always work, but I'm trying to convince myself I don't need it. But do I buy the hype? I do buy the hype. I'm one of those. I buy into it.
I'm sick of this.
I know.
I'm sick of this. This is new, and this has an update, and this is changing, and the format of this. Every time you open your Facebook or you open your phone, there is a new format. There's a new look to something.
Yes.
And I get it. I get that it happens, and you start creating all these new updates. I think it's the frequency of them.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't I just update my phone? Didn't I just get 7.1? Well, now there's 7.2. All right. As soon as I download that, guess what's next? 7.3 or whatever it is. Whatever newfangled thing that these kids are using.
These crazy kids, get off my lawn with your iPhone.
No, this is something though that I'm going to let it phase out. Do I respect them for constantly doing the updates and trying to make our lives easier? Yeah, I do, because this is the world that we live in. But at the same time, I am not going to fork over that much money. I'm also going to let the kinks get out of the system.
Right. Good
you
idea.
You know, with any time they open this, hey, did you download that? Well, you shouldn't, because my iPhone just crashed.
Right.
Whatever it might be. So I'm going to let this run its course.
Mm-hmm.
When it's cheaper and when I'm up for a free upgrade,
then
I will probably get the new one.
Then you'll go into it.
Which won't be the new one anymore.
But I do. I love all this stuff. You know what? It's one of my faults. It's one of those things that I have loved always. Even before the iPhone, like some new gadget would come out, some new
Atari.
Atari, yes!
That's not a joke.
That is the absolute truth. When Atari came out, I couldn't get it. I saved my money and I walked. I remember throwing like a fit, walking to Child World on Newport Avenue to get my
Child
Atari.
World.
I was set on getting an Atari. Did I get the Atari? Yes, I did. And then I got Commodore 64. Don't be jealous.
I won't, because I get my Nintendo and I'm playing Mario Brothers. All right, Brendan, you sick of it? Are you buying into the hype or what?
No, who are these people waiting in line? Can you imagine? Like, what is this? What is your life? Well, most importantly, here's what our Facebook friends are saying about this topic today. Kara Tall leads us off today. $600+ for an updated version of a phone when they offer the same updates for the previous version?
Mm-hmm.
No, thank you. I'll keep my less prettier phone.
And it's bigger, too.
It is bigger.
Yeah. Ada Bronco continues, no, and I never felt the need to go sit in line for hours or even days for it. I don't get it. And lastly today, Patricia Adelio Estrella says, I'm not one to jump on the bandwagon. I always wonder what the profit margin of a new phone, as time goes by, they practically give it away.
They do.
You can get it cheaper later on, absolutely. I'll stick with my Motorola StarTech. Well,